US troops in live fire training.
Edgar, get prepared to move.
On what some fear could be Europe's next battlefield, the sandy plains of Lithuania on NATO's eastern frontier, barely an hour's drive from the border with Russia. Training here is intense, and with good reason. No one doubts Russia could provoke a confrontation. Nearby, in joint exercises, the pressure is on to get Lithuanian recruits up to snuff too.
The Russian activities in Crimea and in eastern Ukraine show that it's not only that Russia possesses the capability to harm us, but they also might have the intentions.
So worried has the Lithuanian government become, they've massively upped defense spending and restarted conscription that was cut 8 years ago. They've been flooded with volunteers.
Watching our neighbors bringing greater and bigger weapons and making big practices at our walls, well, it just seems threatening to me.
And this is where the threat is greatest, Lithuania's border with Russia's Kaliningrad region. These days, tensions keeping crossings down. Although it doesn't look like much from this side of the border, Kaliningrad is a key strategic military hub for Russia, an important naval base and home to an integrated land, sea and air missile system that projects deep into Europe. But it is an enclave. Kaliningrad is isolated from mainland Russia, and that's key to what worries the Lithuanians about what Russia might do next.
In principle, for the tanks and then also for self-propelled artillery.
Nervous enough for the government to tell its citizens what to do in case they're invaded.
And then we are going into, let's say, light weaponry.
We got an advanced copy of the new manual. It goes way beyond the humorous guidance of previous publications.
This is intelligence gathering, it's survival, and it's forming a resistance force.
Yes. Yes, exactly, exactly.
We are doing everything to stop the war outside our borders. We demonstrate that every aggression who will cross the borders, he will have strong resistance from our society, from our military forces.
Help from NATO is ratcheting up too. The French Air Force, just one of a number of NATO nations, wrapping up intercept missions over the Baltics. Mostly monitoring Russian flights to Kaliningrad, a tiny Lithuania. The support is vital.
President Putin understands only power against the power.
By any measure, Lithuania's sandy plains are becoming witness to Europe's new Cold War. Nick Robertson, CNN, Eastern Lithuania.